Hello students, I hope you all are learning your lessons well. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, lesson 5th, and the title of the lesson is Quality, which is written by John Galesworth. Students, do you know, whenever we buy something, whether it is eatable things or house material or something else, but first thing is that we try to maintain its quality. That is why the title of the lesson is Quality, and we all are quite familiar with the word quality. And same way, the story is based on quality. And basically, this story is about two shoemakers who were basically from Germany, and they were living in London. We can say they were cobbler. They were making shoes, and the people who were coming to them, they were always loving these two people. Why? Because they were maintaining a good quality. And you can see here in the picture, the person who is visiting him now and then, the author's father was going to these people, these Gessler brothers. You can see here the name of the shop is Gessler brothers. And you can see the author is noticing while passing through that way. Let us see now Mr. Gessler's shop. You can see here in the picture how Mr. Gessler is working there, and this is author who is visiting him whenever he wants some new boots or so and so. Only a few pairs of boots were in the window. We can see here, only few boots were lying there in the window. The author is trying to tell us, whenever he used to go to the shop, only few pieces of boots were lying there. Mr. Gessler was not making much boots. Mr. Gessler made only what was ordered. What was the reason only few pairs were there? Because Mr. Gessler were making only ordered boots, not simply whatever he likes. It was not possible to go to him very often. Now the author is trying to tell us why people were not going to him often. Reason was that Mr. Gessler, who was making his boots so beautifully, his fitting was so well, the quality of leather was so well, so that is why the customers had no complaint about anything. That is why it was not possible to go to him very often. People were not going to him after buying the boots. Mr. Gessler stood wearing a leather apron with sleeves turned back. You can see here how he is wearing leather apron. This is leather apron, and he is wearing, and his sleeves, he was keeping his sleeves folded one. The author used to enjoy resting in the chair. Now the author is trying to tell how he is feeling there whenever he used to go to Mr. Gessler's shop. You can see here the author is sitting here on the comfortable chair, and he is enjoying that moment. And why? Because Mr. Gessler, he is going now and then, here and there, and to take certain things, and the author is sitting and enjoying that thing. Now about the cracked boot. What happened? The author is having many pairs of boots. He noticed that his new boots were kicked, and that is why he was trying to take those cracked boot to the to Mr. Gessler. Now, possible reason Mr. Gessler told that you might have get them wet before they found themselves. Now, Mr. Gessler, he is trying to tell the reason. What could be reason that these boots are cracked? He said, you might have get them wet. You might have not took care of the boots. You might have made it wet. So that is why this type of problem arised. He suggested author to get the shoes back. While talking, he said that whatever, if you are having that type of problem, you can get it back to me and I'll see if it is possible. I'll see if the boots are made by me, and if it is my fault, definitely I'll reduce some amount of your new shoes. So that is why he is trying to make him understand. And those are not my boots, said Mr. Gessler. Now, when author had gone to Mr. Gessler with the cracked boots, and he observed those boots, and he recognized that those boots were not his, but they were bought from somewhere else. And that is why Mr. Gessler says, those are not my boots. The boots which were cracked, who were brought by author, he says, these were not my boots. Now, Mr. Gessler talked about the hardship. So far, the author was questioning on his hardship. Why? Author is trying to tell that the boots which he brought to the shop, they were cracked. He did not say that he had bought these boots from other firm. Big firms get all by advertisements or not by work. Presently, I have no work. You know that big firm. So far, Mr. Gessler is having small shop where he is trying to make his boots so well so that the customers could be satisfied. And now he is talking about the big firm. He says big firms all get all by adversities, not by work. You know that we run behind the advertisement. Big firm, they spend lot of money on advertisement to attract customers, and we people, we do not have that much money to spend on advertisement. So that is why generally people run behind the advertisement. Whatever is shown in the advertisement, they try to follow those things and they buy. The same thing happened with the author also. Author also bought certain boots from the big firm, and now they are cracked. So that is why Mr. Gessler says that big firm get all by advertisement, because they are spending lot of money on advertisement. Now, presently I have no work. That is the reason the people are running towards the big firm, and the people who are doing hard work, who are giving material which are maintaining good quality, but they are not getting proper work. And it gets less every year, year by year. Customers are becoming less. Why? Because they are running behind the big firm, and these people, they are getting less work. So, author ordered many pairs after hearing the plight of Mr. Gessler. Now, the author is taking pity on Mr. Gessler. He says that we do not have much work. though we are maintaining good quality and in terms of fitting or leather quality, everything we are maintaining in a such a manner, but then also we are getting less work. So author took pity on Mr. Gessler, and after hearing his hardship, he ordered many pairs after hearing the plight of Mr. Gessler. Now, he was not able to go to him for nearly 2 years after that. Now, try to understand this sentence. He was not able to go to him for nearly 2 years after that. What does it mean? After ordering many pairs of shoes, when he got it, he was so comfortable, he was satisfied, he had no complaint. That is why he did not go to him for nearly 2 years. Till 2 years, he did not go to Mr. Gessler. Now, next morning, next time, when Otha visited Gessler's shop, after 2 years, try to understand, after 2 years, Mr. Gessler, again he went to the Gessler's shop. He came to know that his older brother was dead. After 2 years, that means 2 years is a long time period. During this time, he did not go to Mr. Gessler's shop, and when he went there, he came to know that his older brother was no more, though there were two brothers and they were working together, but his older brother, he was no more. He was so sad to hear this, that his best friend, he was his regular customer. This time, author again ordered several pairs and described the fit was better than ever. Now, again, so far, Mr. Gessler, he doesn't talk much to anyone. But only author was the person who was very familiar with Mr. Gessler and Gessler brothers. So he was sharing his own feelings about his brother, about his material and his personal things even. He was sharing with the author, and that is why he shared that, yes, my older brother is no more. And this time again, the author was so sad to hear this, and again he took pity on him that these people are doing so hard. You can see here how he is working there in the picture, and they were not taking care of themselves. Once they start the work, they were so dedicated. They were always trying to satisfy the customers. So that is why once they start the work, they forget their food and so on. So he again ordered several pairs and describe the fit was better than ever. He says that, yes, I need some more shoes. So he ordered, and he says about the fit, that shoes should be comfortable, the quality should be good enough, and this and that. Next, author goes to abroad again. Now, in the first, he had gone abroad for 2 years. After 2 years he visited, and after coming that, again he is going to abroad. The author came back after a year, and at first he went to his old friend's shop again. If you talk about the author is so loving person. He was always trying to help the needy person. So again, when he came back from the abroad, again he went to the shop where his old friends were working. The author mentions that, I left a man of 60, I came back to one of 75. what does it mean? The author mentions that I left a man of 60, the age of 60 when the person was, and he left. I came back to one of 75. Within 1 year, a 75 cannot be like that. But try to understand, what does it mean? It means a person who was at the age of 60, his physical fitness was similar to man of 60. But when he came back, one of 75, that means during this time period, Mr. Gessler, he had become so weak. His physical fitness was mentioning that he was not well. He was not having food or all necessary things enough. So that is why he says, when he came back to one of 70, 75 years old, the person who was at the age of 60, but he was looking like 75 years old man. That means this difference he could see to the Mr. Gessler. Do you want any boots? He said, I can make them quickly. It is a slack time. Now you see, he is speaking this way because he was from Germany, and he was trying to speak English, but in the German tune. That is why he says, do you want any boots? Want. Instead of want, he is using the word want any boots. He said, I can make them. Actually, we say them. Instead of them, what he is using? Them. Quickly, it is a slack time. Slack time. Slack time means a person who does not have much work. He is almost free. So that is why he says that I have enough time. What do you want? If you want board, I'll make those boots as soon as possible because I have enough time. I answered, please, I want boots all around, every kind. So if we talk about the author is always ready to help others. That is why as soon as this gentleman, he says that, yes, what I can help you? Can I do something for you? So he said, yes, I want boots, this and that. Because he heard that his elder brother is no more. Now he is alone there. So, and again he is getting less work. That is why he was trying to give him some work. So that's why I answered, please, I want boots all around, every kind. Then, when the boots came in, he tried them one by one. After ordering that, after a few days, the author went to the shop and he saw that the gentleman who prepared, who made boots so well, his fitting and this and that, everything was well, and he tried them one by one and he was comfortable, he was satisfied. The author describes that this pair of boots he had made, they were best in terms of fit. His fitting was so well, his finishing was so well, and best quality of leather. Three things he mentioned: that his fitting was so well, his finishing was also very good, and the best quality of leather. And because of this, the author, he always used to go to the shop and trying to make himself comfortable. And you can see here how Mr. Gessler is working in his shop. The author right away posted a check. After that, what happened? He discussed lot of things. Yes, we have this and we had that. And in between that, he also talked about big firms. And the author also says that yes, big firms, they do not have that type of finishing. And here you can see here how he describes his three things: his fitting, his finishing, and best quality of leather. Now, after talking this, he tried to give him certain things. He posted a check, and after that he went away. Then, now next day visiting. After that, when he went back to home, and he realized whatever Mr. Gessler is giving him service, his service was well, so well, his was so good. So he wanted to thank him personally. And the author wanted to thank Mr. Gessler for his beautiful art, but he could not found there. Now next day he wanted to thank Mr. Gessler personally, and for that he went to the shop, but he was surprised. Why? He did not found Mr. Gessler there. What happened? An Englishman says that Mr. Gessler is no more. You can see here in the picture. This is Mr. Gessler Brothers shop, and you can see here on the top of the shop, the board was not written there, and the whole shop was totally changed. Instead of Mr. Gessler, he found that an Englishman was standing there, and he says that Mr. Gessler is no more. When he heard that Mr. Gessler is no more, he shocked. Why? Because few days or previous day he met him, and today you are telling that he is no more. How it is possible? Then he describes the reason. He says who? The Englishman, he says that yes, Mr. Gessler, he was so dedicated person, he was so honest, he always tried to satisfy the customers. That is why once he take the work, he used to forget his food and water and so on. So that is why the reason was his death was slow starvation. That means he was not taking food in time. He was not doing his all necessary things in time. That was the reason that he was no more. So this way, Mr. Gessler, again, he also died, his elder brother also died, and at the end of the story, the author is shocked why these two gentlemen who was so honest, so dedicated, they did not take care of themselves. And that is why it is necessary, whatever we do, but the thing, duties are of course it is first, but we also remember that whatever necessary things are there which we require for our day-to-day life, we need to follow this. Okay, this was the story. I hope you understood. Thank you.